In this lesson, we're looking at plotting points from a table of values. So previously we looked at plotting a coordinate in the form of something like 2, 4, where 2 is my x coordinate and 4 is my y coordinate. We know that in order to plot this, we would go along the x axis and then up or down the y axis, depending on if it was positive or negative. So in this case, it would look like this, where I've gone across to the 2 and I've gone up 4, and that is my coordinate right there. Now we want to look at a different form of plotting on a plane. We want to look at a table of values. So let's say the number of goals we scored in football over the season. The table would look something like this. So I've got X designated as the game number. So in my first game, I scored 3 goals, and the goals scored I'm calling Y. So if I wanted to display these values graphically, we could plot the X value, which is the game number, and the Y value, which is the scores in that game, on a Cartesian plane. It would look like this. So if we look here, X is my game number. So if I go across to game 1, I scored 3 goals, which was my Y value. In game 2, I scored 4. Game 3, I scored no goals. Game 4, I scored 3. Game 5, I scored 1. So really, I just treat the table like a bunch of coordinates, and all I need to do is identify and match up the X value and the Y value. So here, in my 5th game where I scored 1 goal, this is the same as the coordinate 5, 1. Okay, now we're going to do some practice questions. So on this page here, we've got question exercise 12b. For each of the following tables of values, plot the points on a number plane. So you can use this number plane here I've given you. I've scaled it appropriately. If you open up the document and find this page, feel free to just draw on it here. Same thing with question 6. The set of points in the table alongside lie in a straight line. So here they're telling you it's a straight line, but you're missing points. So I want you to use what you know about straight lines, about how much x increases and how much y increases. If it's a linear relationship, remember linear and straight line, hand in hand. I want you to complete the table of values, identify the point on the straight line which lies on the x and y axis. So we're expecting that once we draw this line, it'll cross the x axis and the y axis at some point, and they want you to identify which point that is.